Operating System Services. We can start with the file system. A file system is used in the internal memory and in the pen drive connected to the USB port. The internal memory is 128 MB, either in CPico and CPico Mini, and it is divided in two parts, a private memory, 32 MB, and a public memory, about 90 MB. In the first part, the system saves the application files, that is the result of the compilation of C-Strategy and C-Mask, the configuration files like chiller to compressors, chiller for compressors, and so on. And there are also the 4 MB of logs, where the data logger saves the values. An important feature of the private memory is that is fail-safe. To better understand the advantage of this feature, we can see a possible scenario of memories that are not fail-safe, like the pen drive. I don't know if you have never tried to disconnect the pen drive while you were uploading, you were copying a file. If you are lucky, you lose only that file. If you are unlucky, or in the worst case, you may corrupt the whole file system and lose everything in the pen drive. In this case, this can't happen because it is fail-safe. So we have implemented a technology called journaling that prevents the corruption of the whole file system. For example, if while you are uploading the application or while you are uploading the operating system, there is a blackout or you disconnect the cable, you won't have a brick in your hands. But because you have lost all the content of this area, but you would lose only the file that you were uploading. So just upload again the application files or upload again the operating system and that's it. Another feature of this memory is that it is never exposed externally. That is the only way to read or write these files is using CFactory to upload application files or use the export function to export the logs. The public flash memory is about 90 MB that can be extended in some models of CPico with a standard micro SD card. So rather than 90 MB, we can have several gigabytes of space. This memory is formatted in FAT32, okay, this is just a technical detail. You can access to this memory through FTP protocol, file transfer protocol, we will see later on, or using a USB mass storage device protocol, that is a disk. So now I'm connecting the USB cable to the controller, and here is, so F, so you see that it appears like a pen drive. So this is the content of the 90 MB of space. There are some files, these are the logs that I have exported in the tutorial 20, and this is the import-export file of the tutorial 21, or vice versa, and there are also other folders. So this is just a disk. In this memory you can save upgrade packages, and we will see in the tutorial 26, the next one, what they are and how to use them. Here you can export, we have just seen, export the logs, the alarms, we can export, import the parameters. Here you can save the web pages used by the web server, and since it is a disk, you can save any file like the user manual of the application, the commissioning report, or whatever else. Also here in the pen drive, we can save the upgrade packages, import, export the logs, alarms, import, export the parameters like here. Operating System Services USB. Well, this slide summarizes the key points of this topic. I prefer to see the next two slides because are more detailed. So, CPico has two USB ports, one host, that is this one, the other is device. CPico Mini has just one port that behaves at the same time host and device. to use it as this device, just connect it to the controller using a USB cable with the micro USB connector, like the one for the smartphone. Why to use it as a USB host port to connect a pen drive, for example, you have to use a USB OTG cable, USB on-the-go cable, or use a pen drive that has the double connector, USB and also micro USB. What can we do with the pen drive? We can use it to upload upgrade packages, also called application packages, but there is a specific tutorial, the next one, the number 26, about this topic. So let's go on for now. As we saw also before, we can export here in the pen drive the logs using the export log function block. You can select the drive, the USB or the internal memory, enable to export the time period and the log that we want to export. It is possible to export also using a mask in the system menu, but we have seen this in the tutorial number 21. We can export the alarm logs using the export alarm. Okay, this is very similar to the previous one. And we can export import the parameters using the import export params blocks. And we have seen this in the tutorial number 20. These operations, that is export logs and also the upgrade package, can be done, performed either USB, using the USB or the public flash memory, according to what device is connected. So, if when you run that function, the pen drive is connected, it will export there, else the system will export in the public flash memory. USB device port, so you can use this to connect the CPICO to the PC in order to upload the application using CFactory. We saw that you can see the internal memory as a disk. I'll try again. Okay, here is the disk. And you can use this connection for the debug online. And we have seen this in the slide 46. Operating System Services Ethernet. This slide summarizes what are the services and protocols that are available. Next slide contains more details. Ethernet card. It is available in all models of CPICO, while for CPICO Mini only in the high-end model. It provides a galvanic insulation. By the way, there is only one Ethernet card, that is just one IP and one MAC address. In case of CPICO, there are two ports, two switched ports, that is inside there is a small switch, two ports switch. This allows long network chains, as we have seen in a previous exercise. So we can, let's say, enter into the CPICO from a port and exit from the other port without using an external switch. That is required in case of CPICO Mini. The IP can be fixed or dynamic. You can configure this in a mask of the system menu. In the settings, TCP IP. So this is a fixed IP, in this case it is automatic IP. Multifunctionality. So the system is able to run multi-protocols, that is several protocols at the same time. So all these protocols can run at the same time. Modbus TCP or UDP master, Modbus TCP or UDP slave, BACnet client and BACnet server, HTTP for Terra, for the web server, FTP and NTP. So, since it is possible to run, for example, Modbus master and Modbus slave at the same time, it is possible to implement a multi-master network like the previous exercise. You see here Modbus master and Modbus slave at the same time. The same for Bucknet because it is a client server. The operating system for security reason has a firewall. So these protocols works only when the Ethernet devices are on the same network. For example, in this moment I have my PC and the CPICO directly connected, so they are in the same network and so they can communicate each other. While, for example, if I move my PC at home, the CPICO and the PC would be in different network, and so the firewall will prevent that a Ethernet device in the public internet communicate with the controller. The only way to pass through the firewall is implement a VPN, because implementing a VPN, the CPICO and the other internet device, PC or another controller, will belong in the same network. Only Terra protocol, so HTTP for Terra and NTP are not behind the firewall. So you can connect CPICO to the Terra service without configuring any VPN. I just mentioned Terra. Terra is the current solution for remote monitoring. In the CPICO platform, Terra is native, while in the PICO platform is optional, so you can connect the controller to the Terra service through a gateway called Terra Box. So it provides the connection to the mobile, through the mobile operator, to the Terra service. While in CPICO, the box is not required, so just connect CPICO to the internet router and that's it. So it is a plug and play connection. There is just one configuration step in CDesign, as we have seen in the previous exercise. Built-in web server. I told many times that the system has a web server. It is completely customizable. You can create the HTML pages and JavaScript using any editor, any commercial editor. Actually, you can also use Notepad. As well, you can use the Karel C-Web, that is a specific editor to create the web pages. There are 90 megabytes of storage where to save the pages that you can extend using micro SD card, as we have seen before. And there are two specific objects that allows to show a sort of a virtual PGD, showing the mask of the controller, and also to show the logs, to plot the logs. Terra is the Karel solution for remote monitoring. In the PICO platform, to connect the controller to the Terra service is necessary a sort of gateway called Terra Box that provides the communication between the controller and the mobile operator, and so that the connection to the cloud. While with the CPICO platform, the Terra Box is not necessary, just connect the controller to the router and that's it. So it is a plug and play connection. Built-in web server. I already mentioned this before. The system has a built-in server. You can create, you can completely customize the pages. The system uses a standard HTML pages and JavaScript, so you can create them using any editor, any commercial editor, as well as Notepad. as well as you can use a current editor called CWeb. There are 90 megabytes of space where to save the web pages, also more in some models using the micro SD card. The system supports dynamic methods, the CGI, and provides a widget to show the PGD, the virtual PGD, and to plot live trends and plot data coming from the internal data logger. But we will see more details. There is a specific tutorial about the web server, that is the tutorial number 27. I have already talked many times about BACnet protocol. BACnet is natively supported, BACnet BAAC and BBC profile. BACnet is a client-server protocol, a sort of master-slave, that can run at the same time. So in CDesign you have to create just one line and not two lines, one for the master and the other for the slave, like for Modbus or Kadel. To use BACnet you need a license, not for the editor but for each controller where you want to use BACnet. For more details regarding the license, you can get in touch with your local sales representative. After that, FTP server, so the system runs an FTP server, file transfer protocol server, that allows from remote to access to the public memory of the controller. So you can copy upgrade packages, you can copy previously exported logs and alarms and also files with the parameters, you can update the web pages and having the access to the memory you can copy any kind of files. It is possible to protect the controller and prevent the communication via FTP, but there is a specific tutorial regarding the protection. It is possible to use any FTP client. Here there are two examples: Internet Explorer, also Edge, and Total Commander. Okay, we can see. So FTP protocol. Okay, it's already here. And here is, so this is the content of the internal memory. It seems empty, but actually it is not empty. We saw before that this is the content of the internal memory. So why we don't see here the files? Because now I have the Pico, CPico connected to the PC, so the Pico has mounted the public flash memory as a USB mass storage device, a disk. So since this memory is used for the disk, the system is not able to access to that memory. So it looks empty. So the solution is just disconnect PC to the controller. So now I just disconnected the cable and refresh, and here are the files. We can quickly test also Total Commander. So FTP connection, I can edit this one, so it doesn't matter the name. The IP of the controller is already the right one. Username and password for default are anonymous and anonymous. Connect. Okay, I had to close the Edge because also Edge was using the FTP server. So finally I'm in, so this is the content of the memory. So I can enter and exit from the folders, I can also copy files from there, and so on. In the next tutorial, I will show you how to copy and use an upgrade package via FTP. So, this is the last part regarding the operating system services.